क्या आ रहा है?
We'll discuss this chapter, algebraic expressions and identities. Let's revise variables and constants. Variables and constants combine to form an algebraic expression. Let's see how. 4 into x is term 1, 3 into y is term 2, and 9 is term 3. Adding them, 4x plus 3y plus 9, we get an algebraic expression. Now, here, in given algebraic expression, 2x plus 4y minus 9, we see that we have variables x and y. For 2x, the coefficient is 2. For 4y, the coefficient is 4. And the constant term is 9. And segregating the terms, we get 2x, 4y and 9. Now let's come to factorizing the terms of an algebraic expression. Considering this algebraic expression, 10pq plus 4p square minus qq, we will learn the factorization here. 10pq plus 4p square plus minus qq. We will first segregate the terms of this expression. Now after segregating the terms, we will factorize each of the term. 10pq as 10 multiplied by p multiplied by q, similarly 4p square and similarly minus qq. So this way we can factorize an algebraic expression, and this method of factorizing an algebraic expression is called the tree method. Now again we consider an expression 3x square plus 5x plus 2. The coefficient is the number in front of the variable in each term. Here 3x square has the coefficient 3, 5x has the coefficient 5, and hence the coefficient is the number in front of the variable. As we see, again, in the expression 3xy plus 1xy, for the first term, the coefficient is 3, and for the second term, the coefficient is 1. Let's revise what we have learned till now. Terms, the things which are added or subtracted to form an algebraic expression. Factors, factors are what we can multiply together to get the term. Coefficients, the numerical factor of a term is called its coefficient. Sometimes the part of the term other than the given variable is also called the coefficient. Now let's see different types of expressions. Monomials, the expression containing only one term. Binomial will contain two terms, and trinomial which will contain three unlike terms. So, the word unlike is used here because if an expression contains different like terms, then the like terms can be added together. So, if I have an expression which contains two terms and both of them are like terms, then we can add them together, and hence it will be classified as a monomial only. Let's look at some examples on the board here. I have written four questions on the board. For monomial, I will write M. For binomial, I will write B. And for trinomial, I will write T. So for x square, it can be classified as monomial since it is a single term. X square plus y contains two terms and these are unlike terms. So it can be called as a binomial. X square plus 2x square contains two terms and both of them are like terms, and we can add them and we get 3x square. So it is again a monomial and not a binomial. Next expression, x plus y plus z contains three terms which are unlike terms. It can be written as a trinomial. And hence, we learn the different types of expressions like this. Now, let's see like terms and unlike terms. The terms having the same factors are called like terms, otherwise they are called unlike terms. For example, 3x square and 7x square are like terms. 6w and 6y are unlike terms. 585 and 100 are like terms. 4x and 4xy are unlike terms. We cannot add 4x with 4xy together. Similarly, 6w and 6y cannot be added or subtracted. But 3x square and 7x square can be added or subtracted. Now, addition of algebraic expression. In adding algebraic expressions, we collect different groups of like terms and we find the sum of like terms in each group. Here, we have an example. We'll try it on the board. Is added with 5x minus x plus 9. We open up the brackets and we write all the terms now to collect the like terms. So in the second step, I have written all the terms together which are like and all those terms together which are unlike from the previous terms. So the terms which have x as a factor are all like terms, and solving them we get 7x plus 5x minus 4x minus x, we get 7x, and adding 5 and 9 we get 14, and hence the answer will be 7x plus 14. Let's move on to subtraction of algebraic expressions. In order to subtract an algebraic expression from another, we change the signs from plus to minus or from minus to plus of all the terms of the expression which is to be subtracted, and then the two expressions are added. For example, 7x minus 4x plus 5 minus 5x minus x plus 9. So now when we open up the second bracket, I will change the signs of all the terms inside the bracket. So second step becomes, here we have changed the signs of all the terms in the second bracket, and after solving we get minus 2x minus 4 as the answer. Next is the multiplication of algebraic expression, multiplication of a monomial by a trinomial. When we multiply 3p with an expression 4p square plus 5p plus 7, we will first multiply 3p with the first term, then 3p with the second term, and then 3p with the third term of the given trinomial. Multiplication of two binomials, multiplying 3x plus 2y and 5x plus 3y. We will perform the similar method. Let's see it on the board. I will first write both the terms in different brackets. Now take up first term from the first bracket and multiply it with the second bracket, and then take up second term from the first bracket and multiply it again with the whole of the second bracket. Now multiply the terms one by one. After multiplying, we check out the like terms, we combine them and we add them or subtract them together as desired. And we get our solution. Now, multiplication of a binomial by trinomial goes through the similar method only. Multiply a plus b with 2a minus 3b plus c. We will first write down a in multiplication with the whole of second bracket, then b in the multiplication with the whole of second bracket. Multiplying a with 2a minus 3b plus c gives 2a square minus 3ab plus ac, and then multiplying b with 2a minus 3b plus c gives 2ab minus 3b square plus bc. Combining the like terms, I get 2a square plus ab plus ac minus 3b square plus bc. Now, what is an identity? Identity is an equality which is true for all values of the variables. This is an important part of this chapter. Identity 1 is a plus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, that is square of the sum of two terms is equal to square of first term plus square of second term plus 2 multiplied by first term multiplied by second term. For the proof, we write down a plus b square is equal to a plus b multiplied by a plus b, and performing the operation of multiplication on two binomials, we will get the result. Identity 2, a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, that is square of the difference of two terms is equal to square of the first term plus square of the second term plus 2 into first term into second term. For the proof, a minus b whole square is equal to again a minus b multiplied by a minus b. Applying the method of multiplication of a binomial with binomial, we get the result as a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Identity 3, a plus b into a minus b, that is first term plus second term into first term minus second term, which is equal to square of first term minus square of second term. For the proof again, we use the method of multiplication of two binomials and we are able to prove it. Now, before I leave, I'll like to revise all the three identities that we have learned. First identity is a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab, or you can say a square plus 2ab plus b square. Second identity is a square minus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a minus b whole square. Third identity, a minus b into a plus b gives a square minus b square. So thank you. This was the revision of the identities.